NBA on NBC. The 1999 NBA Finals.
The Alamodome in San Antonio is approaching a madhouse. Nearly 40,000 on hand to watch their Spurs, the NBA's best team over the course of the season, take on one of the league's biggest surprises in many seasons, the New York Knicks, with the NBA championship at stake. This will not be the biggest crowd in NBA Finals history. They put more than 40,000 into the Silverdome for the Pistons and Lakers in the late 80s, but this will be way up there, something close to 40,000, ready to roar. Let's check with the Mavericks out.
All right, thanks, Bob. The San Antonio Spurs have been playing so well the last month or so. They've only played 4 games in 24 days, so it brings you to think, are they rusty? Well, I talked to Avery Johnson about it. Avery says that what they've done is they've had game-type scrimmages every other day with conditioning being done the odd day. He said that it's nothing like playing in a real game, but that's the best that they could do. He said the big contribution came from Steve Kerr. Steve Kerr told everybody exactly what the Chicago Bulls did in that situation, what their mindset was. Avery said that has worked, and he feels like they're ready to go. Now for the Knicks side of it, let's go down to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Ahmad. I spoke to Jeff Van Gundy and to Larry Johnson, and here is the reason that Johnson is starting. Johnson went to Van Gundy and told him that he is feeling much better and he'd like to give it a try. He doesn't know how long he can play or how effective he will be. And the reason that Van Gundy bought it was because Johnson had this exact same injury back on March 30th against the Pacers. He missed one game, didn't play for 5 days, had 5 days rest, and came back against the Pacers on April 4th and was very effective. He played 30 minutes off the bench and had 16 points. So Van Gundy feels that Johnson knows his body and he needs him in there to guard David Robinson, and he hopes he's just as effective as he was in the first round against Alonzo Mourning. Van Gundy went on to say that he'll find out real early if in fact he can be effective and he won't have to guess and wait. Bob?
Jim, thank you. Tremendous hand a moment ago for George Gervin, one of the great players in NBA history, one of the 50 greatest, but also one of the great players in ABA history. And the ceremonial first ball will be with a red, white, and blue ball. The Spurs are the first former ABA team to ever make it this far in pursuit of an NBA championship.
Bob, this is going to bring back a lot of great memories for you. You have a lot of ABA roots in St. Louis. This has to make you feel very good.
Baseline bones at the old Hemisphere Arena. In a sense, it's a 26-year wait for both of these teams. The Spurs came to San Antonio from Dallas, where they were the Chaparrals in 73. The Knicks won their last NBA title in 73. Spurs ball at the outset. Right into Duncan against Douglas. And an illegal defense is going to be called right off the bat.
See, what New York would like to do guarding the post is not double team to start the game. See if they can play them straight up. They don't want to open up three-point shooting. But if they get some fouls, they're going to have to double team.
The officials are Hugh Evans, Steve Jabby, and Bennett Salvatore. Duncan. Off the glass.
That's the completeness that we talked about, his ability to step out on the floor and make that little jump shot off the glass. That's his shot.
Ward around a Johnson screen. Now Houston against Ellie. Ties it at 2.
What great confidence Allen Houston is playing with, coming off a 32-point game in Game 6 against Indiana. That little medium-range jump shot's the one he's going to have to take.
Duncan had it knocked away, regains, and starts it over again with Avery Johnson. Robinson, nice pass to Ellie. The foul is on Houston.
When you talk about David Robinson and Duncan, they can do it all. They can pass, and they're great pass. Mario Ellie cuts to the basket. Allan Houston got caught peeking at David Robinson. The nice back cut against the vision and the three-point play.
The Knicks won game one on the road in each of the three previous playoff series, at Miami, at Atlanta, at Indiana. This is a team that won only 8 road games during the regular season. They've won 6 away from home in the playoffs. Johnson finds Dudley. Robinson with a hand on it, but a foul.
That's That's where Dudley's going to have to be effective, Bob. He cannot shoot the ball from the outside. But as Larry Johnson drove to the middle, David Robinson came over to help. Dudley flashed right to the front of the rim. Now, the problem is he's a very poor free throw shooter.
You deal in understatement, my man. He is the worst career free throw shooter in the history of the NBA at 46%. He literally talks to himself at the line, muttering high and straight each time he steps up. But as you see over his career, he's nearly made Wilt Chamberlain look like Rick Barry. In the playoffs, he's at 40%. One of two. Johnson looking for Robinson. Dudley broke it up. Out of bounds off the Knicks.
New York plays great weak side help, Bob. They're not a great shot blocking team without Camby. He changes the game, but they do a nice job of helping when you get cutters coming from that weak side.
Robinson guarded by Johnson. Dudley over for the block. Sprewell's first touch, first shot, off the back iron. Rebound Duncan. Robinson in traffic, and a whistle from Hugh Evans. Stay right here, he says. Foul is on Johnson, his first.
Larry Johnson is going to try to use his strength and muscle on David Robinson. And the reason Robinson's in the post is because they feel they have the matchup there size-wise. So they move Duncan out on the perimeter, and they're going in the post. And they'll do it once again here to try to get Larry Johnson another foul.
Here he goes, another whistle. And they got just what they came for. Number two on number two.
This is the concern for Jeff Van Gundy going into this series. They cannot get in foul trouble. You go back to the matchup, Larry Johnson undersized, he's strong, but David Robinson just muscles into the lane and gets the foul.
And this is going to bring Kurt Thomas off the bench. So the big story at the start of the game was that Johnson could play. Barely 2 minutes in, the story is he has to sit.
Such a mismatch in the size, Bob. As they were being introduced, the starting lineup, I looked to you and I said, look how short the Knicks starting team is. So we'll see Camby soon, but they want to let Dudley play here a few minutes before they bring him in.
Ward, whose performance during the regular season and playoffs has been off from a year ago, gives it up to Sprewell. Poked away, and Duncan has it. Ellie tried to sprint ahead. Now he gives it to Sean Elliott. They almost had the break, but Ellie couldn't find the handle. Duncan. Elliott. Missed what would have been a two. His toe was on the line. Here comes Sprewell. Most dangerous in the open court, but he loses it to Avery Johnson. The New York fouls.
You see what New York wants to do. They want to push the tempo, but two quick turnovers by Sprewell. He has a tendency to get careless with the basketball. And that's what he did there. He picked up the foul, but it was good because Robinson was down at the other end. He would have had an easy dunk had he not taken that foul.
Spurs lead at 6-3. Robinson. The rebound to Thomas. Ward for three. Can't tie it. Rebound chased down by Elliott. David Robinson given room by Dudley. Instead, passes up the shot and goes inside to Mario Elie. Spinning baseline and score.
They found the mismatch. Charlie Ward was caught on Ellie. Great patience that time. I really like the way San Antonio has started here, Bob. With all the time off, you expect them to come out and maybe be frenetic. They have been anything but that. Very poised.
Allan Houston. Kurt Thomas. Short with it. Dudley poked it away from Duncan. Houston's jumper is there.
Great screen that time by Dudley. Stepped over and freed Allan Houston. Allan off to a great start.
Robinson screening for Johnson. Now gets it back from him. And hits the 15-footer.
Well, for the team, for the people who have not seen much of San Antonio, that's David Robinson's shot. He loves that little top of the circle. Duncan loves it on the angle where he can use that glass.
Here's Sprewell on the move. Gives it up to Thomas. Dudley on the offensive glass. Thomas again.
Shot blocking compresses. Thomas, Camby, Larry Johnson will have that little jump shot. They have to make that off the penetration from Sprewell in Houston.
After 5 minutes, Spurs by three. Robinson. Contact as he cut through the lane. Could have been a three-point play. Instead, he'll come to the line for two.
You feel the mismatch. You look inside. Great patience. LA takes it to the basket. High over the shot-blocking arm of Kurt Thomas for the score. And then David Robinson fading out and shooting that little jump shot. He makes this one, and it sets up his next play where he drives and gets fouled. What I have seen from David Robinson as we've done these playoffs through the and gone on with this team, he is having fun playing basketball, more so than I've ever seen him have it before. And his love and passion is surfacing. You're seeing more animation from David Robinson.
And he's put his own game behind the team's interests. In the first 9 years of his career, he averaged 25 points a game. This year, just shy of 16 a game. But for the first time, his team is in the finals. Here's Sprewell, goes to the left hand, and a San Antonio foul.
Bob, you can really see what New York is trying to do. They're trying to space the floor to give Sprewell and Allan Houston room to drive to the basket, to get those big guys out of there.
Houston off the inbound. His shot deflected, grabbed by Robinson, pegged ahead to Johnson, but Ward got back with him. Duncan turns and misses off the glass. Dudley is there to clear it. Sprewell using that quickness. High arcer, no good. Robinson pulls it down. Johnson's pass knocked away. Houston comes out of the pack with the steal. They run the break, and Ward finishes it.
That's when New York is at their best, forcing turnovers and running. A great job by Kurt Thomas, fronting the post and knocking that entry pass away from Tim Duncan.
Knicks to within a basket. Duncan against Dudley. Back out to Ellie. Five on the shot clock. Duncan had it knocked away, then forced it up, and Kurt Thomas comes away with it. Knicks looking to tie. It's Ward. Thomas to follow. And Robinson takes it. Avery Johnson all the way to the hoop, tripped up. And the foul will be on Ward.
Bob, my concerns right now, if I'm San Antonio, New York is doing a great job on the offensive board. Kurt Thomas has got a second shot. Chris Dudley's got a couple. Now, the one thing that is going to sustain San Antonio through this period of time, New York already in the penalty, so they're shooting free throws the rest of this quarter. They need to take advantage of that.
Avery Johnson shot 57% at the line this year, the worst of any guard in the NBA, but he upped it to 70% so far in the playoffs. Let's check with Jim Gray.
All right, thanks, Bob. I spoke to Jeff Van Gundy before the game. He was very concerned about his team being emotionally drained. He said they did not practice well the last couple of days. He said he spoke to him very forcefully before the game. He says it's not a death sentence that we didn't have any intensity in practice, but we must come out and turn it up quite a bit if we're going to compete for this championship. Bob?
Jim, thanks. How would you judge the New York intensity so far, Doug?
I think it's been very good. They're moving the basketball. Wide open shot here from Charlie Ward. You got to knock those down, but they're doing a good job here to start.
Ward got a great look at a three and couldn't hit it. Robinson had it poked away and Dudley takes it. Here comes Sprewell. Duncan with it. Spree explodes to the basket and gets the roll.
See, that's what you got to do. You can't flip the ball at the basket. You got to go right at that shot blocker and make him commit. That time, Tim Duncan backed away.
Duncan with the reverse.
Just a matter of time if he's going to be single covered down there to get his feel of what Dudley's doing against him. Then he'll counter and do just what he did there, get the basket.
Sprewell.
Wow, what a shot over Tim Duncan.
How about the quickness at first? Little ball fake, quick flash. Then he pulls up, stops on a dime for the high arcer. Robinson inside, but missed it.
Dudley, a nice job there. That's his second block shot, and it leads to a quick, fast break from Houston. So right now, New York has to be very happy, Bob. They're doing a good job defensively. They're getting out and running. They're getting some second shots. Jeff Van Gundy has to be very happy right now.
Game tied at 15. Greg Popovich is not happy. He wants a timeout. 3:38 to play in the first.
The steal from Kurt Thomas, the knockaway, and Dudley throws the ball ahead, and Mr. Energy, the one-man fast break, Latrell Sprewell, takes it right at Duncan and gets the kind roll. And then Sprewell once again, look at this little medium-range shot. They're not going to let you get all the way to the basket. What a tough fadeaway over Duncan. And then Allan Houston again with that little pull-up. So the Knicks have the idea here. We might not be able to get all the way to the basket. We see the defense, we pull up, and we take what's given to us.
One of the 50 greatest players of all time on these two rosters will finally have his weight end and will receive a championship ring. If it's Ewing, it won't be as an active participant. David Robinson is on the team that's the overwhelming favorite to do it. Marcus Camby making his first appearance in the New York lineup after a little more than 8 minutes of the first quarter. Here's Duncan, surrounded by three defenders and a foul.
Remember in the open I talked about, Marcus Camby has been playing terrific basketball. What he's done, this is a cheap foul, Bob. You cannot reach in. You got to stay big, get the hand up, and make him shoot out over an extended arm. So Marcus Camby comes right in and picks up a quick foul.
Jaren Jackson and Malik Rose are in for San Antonio. David Robinson and Sean Elliott are out.
When I talked to Jeff Van Gundy yesterday, one of the things he talked about was we got to keep San Antonio off the foul line. What it enables them to do when they shoot free throws, they can get their defense back and get set against us. And now we have to work hard to score. So we've got to limit their free throw attempts.
San Antonio leading 17-15. 7 of 9 from the line so far in the first quarter. Houston kicked it into the backcourt. Sprewell picks it up, but it's over and back. San Antonio ball.
The game plan on Allan Houston, take away any catch and shoot. Don't let him come off the screen, catch it, and go up and shoot it. Chase out of his shooting hand, make him put the ball on the floor to drive it inside. That time he forced a turnover.
Chris Childs now comes in. Ward out. Ward's minutes way down in the playoffs. Childs getting the bulk of the time.
Well, with Larry Johnson injured, this is New York's best team that they have on the floor right now. Childs and Camby off the bench.
Avery Johnson gives it up to Mario Elie. The set shot is way off on the attempted three. Sprewell. Guarded by Jaren Jackson. Backing in on him. Finding Camby, who hits over Malik Rose.
See, with David Robinson out of the game now, Camby can go right over the top of Malik Rose. They've lost a shot blocker now, so New York can take that ball to the basket.
Jaren. Aaron Jackson. Big factor against the Lakers and the Trailblazers. Misses his first shot here. But Duncan takes it and gives them a fresh 24. Malik Rose can't knock it down. Up and over the glass. New York ball.
Latrell Sprewell orchestrates his whole play. He backs it out till he gets the double team. He tells Camby, cut to the basket. He sees Malik Rose. He said, I can go right over the top of him. And he scores. But Latrell Sprewell orchestrates this whole thing. He sees Duncan. The minute he comes, Camby cuts to the basket. No David Robinson. They get a layup.
And you're watching the NBA on NBC. Steve Kerr in the game for the first time for San Antonio. He's on Chris Childs. Sprewell driving on Jaren Jackson, but he's rejected. Into the hands of Childs, though. He finds Thomas underneath, and Thomas is clobbered.
I think they're going to call a flagrant also. They took him down. Jaren Jackson and Rose went up, came down, and hit him in the head. And normally any blow to the head, they'll call a flagrant. So you get up in the air. Kurt Thomas gets his man in the air, actually gets Jackson, Duncan, both in the air, and Jackson takes him down, and they're going to call the flagrant. That's two shots in possession. That's a flagrant one.
Let's go to Ahmad Rashad.
All right, thanks, Bobby. Hope we talked about the San Antonio Spurs having a long time out, trying to have the game-type scrimmages, trying to keep their conditioning. But obviously, with the way this game has started, it has not worked. You cannot play practice like it is a game. David Robinson, Sean Elliott, both really tired at this point, trying to get that second win. And it'll take some time because, Doug, as we talked earlier, you cannot really know what it is to have this crowd with this game-type action, try to get your breath back. So they'll recover and they'll be back as the game continues.
Rust is not a problem for Allen Houston. He continues on the roll he was on when they finished off the Pacers.
His confidence level is higher than I've ever seen it before.
And of course, you coached him at Detroit. Here's Malik Rose inside and scoring.
Well, they're going to need some energy from the bench. Get this crowd involved in the game. As Ahmad talked about, let the team get their second breath before they bring them back in.
Sprewell with Jackson on him. Spinning to the baseline and converting on the reverse.
Wow, Latrell Sprewell's off to a great start. That energy and quickness, Bob, you can never put a premium on what high-energy, talented guys bring to your team.
Houston up on Mario Elliott. Slips past him, finds Jaren Jackson alone. He misses the three. It's taken by Childs. He pulls up and fires. It's short. It falls right into the hands of Kurt Thomas for a gift basket.
Looked like Malik Rose tried to flop a little bit there to get the foul. The referee had no part of that, and New York up six now, 30 seconds to go in the quarter.
Ellie, the lob to Duncan. Between two defenders, he puts it in.
How about the catch? How about the catch and the ability to come down as that big guy and lay the ball in the basket?
Knicks looking for the quarter's last shot and leading by four. Houston driving on Ellie, spinning, shooting, and hitting again. Man, if you touched him, you'd singe your fingers. He's that hot. Last 2 seconds. It'll be Jackson from half court. Just missed it. Well, the Knicks didn't come here as foils. They came as foes, up by six after one at the Alamodome, and you're watching the NBA on NBC. On the question of rest versus rust, over the past 20 years, nine teams have taken care of business quickly enough in the conference finals that they had a week or more of rest going into the final. Seven of those nine teams wound up winning it. The two that didn't certainly don't prove that the long layoff hurt them, because last year the Jazz lost to the Bulls, so you can throw that right out. They're against Michael and Chicago. There's many reasons for that defeat. And the other one was the 89 Lakers, who had won 11 straight playoff games, and then in game one, Byron Scott and Magic Johnson both got injured against the Pistons and were out for the rest of the series, and Detroit swept them. Knicks up by half a dozen as we start the second quarter. Sprewell can't increase it, and Duncan takes the rebound.
Bob, the slow start, though, really doesn't surprise me. I think rest really comes into play once you start getting into a series. I think it always pays dividends. Maybe it hurts you in the short run, but not in the long term.
Duncan into the lane, pull-up jumper, good.
Now, how about that play? Tim Duncan, pump fake, drives in the lane and pulls up. Now, this guy's 7 feet one and probably weighs about 260 pounds.
Is he the best player in the league?
He is to me. He's the most complete player, defense and offense. I don't think he has a weakness in his game.
Houston off with the long attempted two. Back come the Spurs, trailing by four. Steve Kerr for three. Not there for him. The all-time leader in career three-point accuracy, and he had a good look at it. Childs pounding the dribble into the floor, now finding Sprewell. Out to Kurt Thomas, Childs again. Shot clock winding down, and a foul. It's on Duncan, his first. Meanwhile, Larry Johnson, who committed two quick fouls and went out after just over 2 minutes of the first quarter, returns.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how he comes back in after getting warmed up, maybe getting a little stiff on the bench with that leg. But Kurt Thomas sits down and Sprewell, so now you have sort of a bigger, slower New York team. Look for them to continue to go through Allen Houston, this team on the floor.
What did Kurt Thomas do while he was in there? 6 points, seven rebounds, two steals. Houston is tripped. Jackson is hit with his second foul.
Allan Houston, as I watch him play here, Bob, one of the things that really registers to me is all his career, he's heard what a great player he could be. I think it's finally registered to him, I'm a great player and that's the way I'm going to play. What confidence he's playing with.
Johnson backs in on Elliott. Ball knocked away. Can be trying to save it, but it winds up in San Antonio's hands. Jaren Jackson, eyes a three. Spurs pulled within one. And Chris Childs is hit with a technical on top of it.
This is the one thing you don't want to do if you're in New York. Get this crowd excited. You're playing well. You get a three-pointer from Jaren Jackson in the transition. Now Steve Kerr is going to shoot the technical. Keep your poise. Don't give this crowd anything to cheer about.
But Kerr can't tie it.
Let's take a look right here at Chris Childs, and let's see what happens after the play is over. He's just going to take and throw his shoulder into Malik Rose. I think Malik did a nice little acting job to go with that. But Chris Childs, important he stays on the floor. He and Canby give him great play off the bench.
Johnson around the perimeter to Houston. Johnson against Rose, backing in. Now here's Childs, 4 seconds to shoot. Canby will. Loose ball battle, and it's out of bounds. And the Knicks are going to keep it. 9:43 to play in the first half. New York by one. Ten points for Houston so far in this one. We're early in the second. Jaren Jackson intercepts Dudley's pass, cutting in front of Johnson, takes it to the hole and misses. Gets it back, finds Avery Johnson, and he decides he'll set it up. Jackson for three. And as they battle for the rebound, there's a loose ball foul. And it's on Malik Rose, his first.
Larry Johnson did a very smart play on that fast break. Bob, he was back. He couldn't take the foul because he already has two. He would have had to sit down with three. So he just sort of put his body up against him and forced him to take a tough shot, and he missed it.
He seems to be moving and jumping pretty well, speaking of Larry Johnson.
I think as the game goes along, he'll feel more trust in that leg. Bob, if you hurt a knee, if you've never done it before, it's a strange feeling. I've done it, and it feels like you're just off balance. The thing is not stable, and the more you can go, the more you trust it, the better you'll be.
Camby against Elliott. Spinning on him, but it looks like a foul or an illegal defense beforehand. Illegal defense. Each team has been hit with one illegal defense warning. On the second, a technical is shot.
See, Camby's in the game right now. He's playing as a small forward against Elliott. Let's see if they go back and try to post him again.
There's number two on Elliott.
Bob, we talk so much about the game being mismatches. That's what it's about. You got a mismatch, you go to it. Go into Camby inside, let him work against Elliott. He has the size.
They go right back to it. The turnaround. Rebound taken by Malik Rose. Jackson's pass intended for Robinson, broken up and stolen. Houston feeling it, but it won't drop. And a foul on Camby as he tries to get up on the offensive glass.
Little push in the back that time by Marcus Camby. That's his second foul. And again, we talked in our open. He's got to stay out of foul trouble. He's in the lane. Rose has inside position. He extends both arms. You're going to get that foul every time.
You know, you get Kurt Thomas in foul trouble, maybe. Larry Johnson, maybe. You can't play Chris Dudley down the stretch of close games because he's such a poor free throw shooter. Ewing is in street clothes, but the way things are going for the Knicks, Herb Williams at age 41 will come off the bench and score 20.
Well, see, I think that's one of the reasons why San Antonio is not panicking right now, Bob. They realize it's a 48-minute game. They want to try to wear New York down. They know they have a depleted front line. Don't panic. Just keep playing. Keep wearing them down.
Foul was on Chris Childs a moment ago, his first.
New York's going through one of those droughts that they go through after a 27-point first quarter. They have not scored in almost 4 minutes.
Robinson is hit as he cuts to the basket. And as he goes to the line, you can go online to MSNBCSports.com and check out a comprehensive playoff section called NBA Showtime Online. Isaiah Thomas breaks down the Knicks and Spurs matchup and picks a champion. Plus, you can email Bill Walton, every fan's dream, at MSNBCSports.com.
Allan Houston getting his first rest, Sprewell in, so you can see the strategy of Jeff Van Gundy. He wants one of those guys on the floor all the time for their scoring. Can't rest them both at the same time.
One of two for Robinson, but Duncan grabs the rebound. Jackson's open for three. Larry Johnson takes it. Chris Childs backing away with his dribble. Johnson screening for him. The jumper is off, and the rebound is taken by Robinson. Avery Johnson pushing it up the floor. Robinson's the trailer for the jumper. Finally, the rebound winds up in Sprewell's hands. After 4.5 minutes of the second quarter, the Knicks have been blanked. Johnson into traffic. And a foul call by Bennett Salvatore. It comes before the shot. It's on Jerome Kersey, his first.
For people who have not seen a lot of San Antonio, I think there's this perception out there. This is a half-court team. Bob, they would like to run, too. In the L.A. series, they ran, and they scored big points. So they want to run back at you. So don't get the feeling here that this is New York style of game, necessarily. San Antonio wants to run also.
Spurs are over the limit already in the period. And so Johnson shoots. You would have thought, from the way he went down late in the series against the Pacers, that we had seen the last of him in uniform in this postseason. It's a far cry from Willis Reed limping out before Game 7 at the Garden 29 years ago, but it's certainly a boost for the Knicks. the unexpected early return of Larry Johnson. Here's Jaren Jackson on the move, and Steve Javi spots a foul. It's offensive against Jackson.
It's on Tim Duncan. What happened, Bob, is as Jaren Jackson drove the baseline, he sealed and moved on that screen, so Duncan got caught with a moving screen on that play.
And that's Duncan's second. Larry Johnson up in a crowd. And the Knicks with a three-point lead at 30-27.
You cannot let Larry Johnson spin. He wants to spin back to that strong hand away from the shot blocker. You must keep him going in the same direction when he tries to post up.
That was their first basket of the period. They only had a free throw prior to that in this second quarter. There's foul number three on Marcus Camby.
Larry Johnson loves to set you up. Drive in the middle, have you cut him off. And then he loves to spin back off your body. Watch him as he gets his position. Kersey will drop. He'll spin off his body and go away from the shot blocking, the pump fake, the kiss off the glass. They need Larry Johnson.
Welcome back to San Antonio. I'm Jim Gray. Larry Johnson is now playing in the game with just the rubber padding around his right knee. He started the game and came out for warm-ups in what's called a medial collateral ligament brace. There you see it. He took it off on his own. Dr. Norman Scott said he advised him not to take it off, but Larry said he was uncomfortable, felt sufficiently warmed up, and now he is playing without it. Dr. Scott said in the newspaper earlier that that would prevent further injury to the medial collateral. However, Larry Johnson is now at some risk, but he feels this is what he has to do to compete. Bob?
Jim, thanks. Spurs ball. They trail by three. David Robinson cuts it to one.
That little isolation play. They love to bring David Robinson out to that free throw line extended and let him use his quickness. That time he scores against Kurt Thomas.
Kersey's on Johnson. And Johnson picks up his third as he's hit with the offensive foul.
Foul trouble is really going to hurt this New York team. They are depleted on the front line. Kersey reads the play beautifully. That's Larry Johnson with three. We also know that Camby picked up a quick three. This will really hurt the New York Knicks.
Johnson has logged just 7 minutes of playing time, and he sits with three fouls. Mario Elie checks back in for the Spurs, and Kersey goes out. A little pressure in the backcourt from Childs. Duncan comes back, sets a screen for Avery Johnson, and he comes across. And Kurt Thomas is whistled for a foul. That's his second. So the Knick lineup now has Childs and Houston in the backcourt, Thomas and Sprewell at the forwards, and Dudley at center for Jeff Van Gundy. Prior to this year, David Robinson had played in 62 career playoff games and scored 20 points or more 45 times. This year, he's topped 20 points only twice in 12 playoff games, as the focus of the offense has shifted to Tim Duncan as the first option.
When David Robinson scores big, he normally does it by getting to the free throw line a lot. You're seeing that in the game tonight. Drawing, getting contact, getting to the line.
Sprewell to Thomas from 20. Overshot it badly. Jackson and Dudley chasing after it. And a loose ball foul on Jaren Jackson.
Dudley's really working hard on that offensive board. That's at least three offensive rebounds he gets. And what it enables you to do, Bob, if you shoot a low percentage and you get the extra shots, it gives you more opportunities. And Dudley has done that tonight.
Third foul on Jaren Jackson. High and straight, Chris Dudley says to himself. Let's see how well he does. One for two so far tonight. tomorrow on NBC, America's Funniest Night of Television. Must-see TV Thursday starts at 8, 7 Central with Friends, then Jesse, Frasier, plus Will and Grace and ER. A great night. Must-see TV tomorrow night on NBC.
Now, Bob, the ironic thing about the New York foul trouble right now is you would expect Chris Dudley to be a guy who normally picks up quick fouls. He has none. It's been Camby and Larry Johnson tonight that's gotten the fouls.
Even at 31, Avery Johnson finds Duncan open. Can't untie it, and the rebound to Thomas. Sprewell with 6 on the shot clock now. Childs inside to Dudley. 2 seconds to shoot. Thomas beats the buzzer and misses off the back iron. David Robinson. And the rebound to Dudley. Sprewell pulls up and gives New York the lead.
Oh, that's a 1-on-4. You're talking about confidence. He just comes down the floor and lets it go, but that's the way you got to let Sprewell play. You can't restrict him. He'll make some bad plays, but he's going to give you a lot of positive energy, and he's scoring very well right now.
Childs all over Avery Johnson, runs him into a Duncan screen. Now up top to Robinson, the Admiral on the drive, and a foul on the play. It will go against San Antonio. It's Robinson's second.
Again, the one-man fast break. Chris Childs threw ahead to Sprewell, let him go to work. You see 4 white jerseys back there. Elliott with a hand in the face does not bother Latrell Sprewell.
Ellie went for the steal. That left Houston open.
Got to square him up. The way Allan Houston is shooting, you cannot give him those easy looks. And right now, New York is in a very good rhythm. They're going through Sprewell and Houston. The only thing that could really hurt them is foul trouble right now.
Ellie against Dudley. Swings it back outside to Duncan. And Duncan lays it in.
Looks like Dudley hurt his wrist on that play, or his elbow. They can ill afford another big guy to get hurt right now.
He gets to his feet and joins his teammates, but Jeff Van Gundy's taking no chances. He asks for time.
Chris Dudley's going to try to step over in front of Tim Duncan to take this charge. Duncan pulls up. They do not call him. He lands. You can see him land hard on that right wrist. We'll see how he is after the timeout.
No question that the team envisioned by the now deposed general manager Ernie Grunfeld had Marcus Camby and Latrell Sprewell getting big minutes and the team playing a more wide open style. That's happened in part because of injuries to Patrick Ewing, which forced the change.
Well, you know, he had injuries to Patrick. He really was never healthy all season long. Sprewell got hurt early in the season, was out. They really never had it all together. And with this shortened season, Bob, it's taken them till now to really find out who these guys are, what they can do out on the floor.
Just in the nick of time. And the Knicks by 2. Here's Houston, feeling it, but missing it. The rebound taken by Duncan. The outlet to Avery Johnson. The bounce to David Robinson. Robinson against Dudley, who bothered the shot. The ball kicked to the side, and Sprewell wins the race for it, but he stepped on the sideline. For a report on Chris Dudley, we check with Jim Gray.
All right, thanks, Bobby. Just kind of fell awkwardly on his right forearm, and it pulled his shoulder and his forearm. Mike Saunders looked at him real quickly. He will continue in the game without a problem. Bob?
Bob, he's playing very well. Just comes off a shot block there against David Robinson. He's done a nice job with all the foul trouble that New York's front line has had here in this first half.
Robinson, meanwhile, has shot 2 for 8 in this first half. Dudley trying to get in front of Duncan and bother him. And he did. It went off Duncan and out of bounds.
Well, there's a possession where he forced a turnover. So back-to-back, shot block, forced turnover.
Childs around the Thomas screen. Now circles back out. We move inside 3 minutes to play in the first half, and Childs misses. The rebound tipped to Duncan. line to the paint, switches hands and misses, but he was fouled on the play. That's number one on Chris Dudley.
Bob, the effect of what San Antonio is doing right now in the low post with Duncan driving in there, you've seen Robinson in the post, is it will have its effect in the second half. Right now you can get a sense the New York front line is tiring a little bit. So San Antonio has to keep pounding that ball inside.
Karl Malone won the MVP award for the second time in his career. Alonzo Mourning of Miami was second and Duncan was third. But a lot of people believe that this is the best all-around player in the league. And one of those believers is Knick coach Jeff Van Gundy.
Well, I think you've really seen his game blossom in the playoffs.
Here's Sprewell. Gets it back from Dudley. Spins and fires. Flat-footed rebound taken by Ellie. Robinson to Duncan.
Wonderful high-low. Wonderful pass there. They get the fronting in the post. They swing it to the top. It makes the extra pass. And you see the great touch of Robinson over the top to Duncan. That's beautiful basketball.
Duncan has scored 16. The Spurs are back in front. Dudley is blocked by Robinson. Into the hands of Avery Johnson. Here's Sean Elliott, who hasn't scored yet. Robinson's open. Spurs by four.
We always talk about the end of half, the last 2 minutes. New York must be very careful right now. San Antonio hitting them with a spurt. Jeff Van Gundy feels it. He takes a 20-second timeout. They do not want to let this half slip away here in the last 2 minutes.
The timeout comes with San Antonio on an 8-0 run.
See, Duncan, he says, throw me the alley-oop. It's not there. He goes into the post. Kurt Thomas is going to get in front of him. So what do? You swing the ball to the top. Now you throw over. There is no weak side help. You get the score. And then Robinson with the block shot. So he has the assist. Now he comes over, and he gets the block shot. And then he goes to the other end, and he hits the jump shot. The complete package, the duo of David Robinson starting to make the mark in this game. Mario Ellie says, I like that passion, David. More importantly, I like that block shot, too.
How about Jerry Rice's comment? Rice, in all likelihood, the greatest receiver in the history of the NFL, but now after injuries and as he gets along in years, perhaps not the top receiver on his own team anymore in San Francisco, he says, I'll have a whole new attitude coming into training camp after watching what David Robinson did this year with San Antonio, willingly taking a secondary role. I'll do that on the football field.
Well, I think it's important because they're winning that you see your reward winning. And that's what David Robinson says. I've been around long enough. I've had the stats. I've had the glory. I've been the MVP of the league. I've been the defensive player. I've led the league in scoring. The one thing I don't have is a ring, and that's what I want.
After a foul by Mario Elie, his first, Houston hits the free throw. And Herb Williams, at age 41, the oldest player in the NBA, 4 years older than his coach, has checked in for the last few moments, last minute and a half of this first half. Here's Ellie against Houston. He was bumped and fouled. And that's three on Allan Houston.
Boy, the fouls are really mounting up. They can ill afford to lose Allan Houston. See, Bob, the problem with that is now, with a minute 24 to go in the half, you worry that Allan Houston comes out and picks up a quick fourth and has to sit down a lot in the third quarter. If you're Jeff Van Gundy, that's your concern right now.
Mario Elie, a good free throw shooter, missed that one. The Knicks are thin to begin with. And three key players in foul trouble in the first half.
Well, part of your game plan is when you play a team that's depleted along that front line is you don't shoot jump shots. You go to the basket and you put the onus on the official to make calls. And that's what San Antonio has done to get through this little period of time where they've struggled to put the ball in the basket.
Robinson goes out. Malik Rose in to replace him. Here's Antonio Daniels against Childs. Daniels goes down. No foul is called. Daniels making his first appearance of the half. Second-year player from Bowling Green. Dudley against Duncan. He'll shoot a little hook, but he won't get the bounce. Here comes Avery Johnson, 2-on-1. Daniels on his right. Antonio Daniels lays it in.
When Chris Dudley's on the floor with Herb Williams, you're actually playing 3-on-5 offensively right now. That's what happened, and San Antonio took advantage of it.
Charlie Ward, Williams, out to Childs. Back to Herb Williams. 6 seconds to shoot. That's the last thing Williams has on his mind. And there's a whistle from Bennett Salvatore.
I don't think New York thought that Chris Dudley was going to take this shot, so they didn't protect the backcourt. Duncan gets it out. He throws ahead. Avery Johnson said, we got an easy 2-on-1. We haven't seen this kind of fast break tonight. So the quick shot from Dudley, I think, sort of surprised his teammates. They did not cover the backcourt.
The foul was on Malik Rose, his second. Sending Dudley back to the line, where he's hit 2 of 4. And now 2 of 6. Spurs maintain a 5-point lead. Last half minute. Duncan's open. And he drills the 20-footer.
That was a set play to go 2 for 1. And now we'll get 2 shots to 1 in that last possession. 3 second shot difference in the shot clock, game clock.
Charlie Ward out to Herb Williams. The tip doesn't drop. And a New York foul. Over the back on Dudley, attempting to follow on the offensive glass. It's his second.
Again, Bob, we talk so much about free throws. Chris Dudley walks up, and he misses 2 free throws. They come down. Duncan scores to give you a 2-for-1 possession. Then he picks up the loose ball foul. That's a big swing right there where you're trying to stop the momentum going in at half with 3 of your players in foul trouble.
With that free throw, Duncan has now outscored the Knicks in this quarter. He's got 11 points. New York has 10. He's looking for his 20th point of the half. And doesn't get it. Last 4 seconds. Pass deflected. Dudley, gonna get off the last shot? Not quite. He claims he was fouled, but he'll get no satisfaction.
San Antonio, with great defense, ends the half on a 14-2 run. So they were down by 4. They now lead by 8.
As we take a look at tonight's leaders, Avery Johnson has not attempted a shot from the field in this game. He took more shots than any Spur in the Portland series because of the way the Trailblazers geared their defense. The shots were there for him. Tonight so far, they have not been. So he's just been the distributor. Here's Larry Johnson, the Knicks with it as the second half begins. And a whistle before Sprewell can do anything with it. A 3-second violation against the Knicks.
See, Chris Dudley thought the shot was going to be taken. And when Sprewell didn't take it, he was in rebound position and got called. Bob, New York's got to get off to a good start here. After that second period, San Antonio's getting into a rhythm, and they're pounding that ball inside. How will they play the post here? Duncan and Robinson, a huge first half.
Mario Elie into Sean Elliott. Elliott and the crowd had it knocked away. Avery Johnson picks it up and finds Duncan. 6 on the 24 as Elie drives and scores. And New York is asking for a 20-second timeout, less than a minute into the third quarter.
Well, Jeff Van Gundy's not happy. They started out with a turnover, and then Mario Elie gets all the way to the rim for a layup. He's saying, look, we got to come over and contest this. We can't give up layups.
Thank you. Little did David Robinson suspect that his injury 2 years ago was going to lead to his best chance ever for an NBA title. I'll explain in a moment as the Knicks lose it on the turnover.
Jeff Van Gundy cannot be happy with that. Charlie Ward is really struggling. He might have to come back quickly with Childs.
Avery Johnson's first shot. And the rebound is taken by Ward. Sprewell. Out to Houston. Gets it back. Working against Ellie, gets a screen from Johnson and pops home the jumper.
New York's run a lot of screen roll tonight. What they're doing is they're counting on the big men not stepping out, and that shot has been there for Houston and Sprewell tonight off that quick screen roll.
Hold on, says Bennett Salvatore, just to go back to the point of a moment ago. In 97, when David Robinson missed most of the season with an injury, the Spurs went 20-62, qualified for the lottery, won the lottery, took Duncan. Without Duncan, there's no way they're here.
Well, if you're going to be bad in the years when you can grab David Robinson and Duncan, and that's what happened to San Antonio, the luck of the lottery.
A decade apart, 87 and 97. Elliott, nice catch inside, switches to the left hand and finishes it.
That's his first field goal. They've made a conscious effort to get him involved. He took one shot in the first half. They need him. And two possessions they've run for him. Now they finally get him a score.
Spurs by 10. And another whistle at the other end. Tim Duncan picks up his third.
Sean Elliott is normally their third best scorer, and they need to get him involved. You see them working very hard in the post. New York's fronting the post. They're taking away any help. So if he catches that ball, he's got an easy layup.
Allan Houston returns it to Ward for a three, and he's got it.
Boy, he needed that one. He had a layup in the first half, but he needed that three because they're really keying on Houston and Sprewell. When they put that ball on the floor, Avery Johnson's going to help.
Here's Sean Elliott, Sprewell guarding him. Ball knocked loose and out of bounds and touched last by San Antonio. Greg Popovich sends Malik Rose in, and Tim Duncan with three fouls will sit for at least a while. Knicks looking to cut into a 7-point deficit. Pass inside, knocked away, but recovered by Sprewell. Off the dribble, he fades and fires. Off the back iron, no good. And Robinson has it. Coming over to help Dudley with Robinson. Cutting through is Avery Johnson, and Robinson finds him.
The double team, and Avery Johnson does what you're supposed to do. You go right to the basket, a great pass from Robinson. And Bob, looked like Malik Rose was going to go up and tip that ball in the basket. He realized the ball was going to fall in, and he pulled his hand back. That ball goes into the post. Charlie Ward starts peeking at David Robinson. Oh, where did Avery Johnson go? He goes right to the basket, and Malik Rose pulls away from that. Looks like he's going to try to go up and maybe tip this ball at the last minute. He pulls his hand away. Smart play, otherwise it would have been goaltending.
And the stoppage a moment ago, not because of a foul. They were just resetting the shot clock, and now we're set. Larry Johnson inches into the paint, bounces out to Sprewell. Head fake on Elliott, but he traveled.
In this season, remember, these two teams have not played each other. They're starting to feel each other out. New York had a great first quarter, 27 points. San Antonio's getting a handle on them defensively. They only have 15 points since then.
And when the Spurs bring the clamps down defensively, you are in trouble. Another foul on Dudley. That'll be his third. For once, Jeff Van Gundy is up against an opposing coach who has a lower national profile than his. He's beaten Pat Riley, Lenny Wilkins, and Larry Bird in successive rounds of the playoffs. Camby coming back.
They've got to keep Camby on the floor. He cannot pick up a silly foul. He had one of three field goals, no rebounds in that first half, no shot blocks. He has got to be an impact player.
Mario Elie has it blocked away by Ward, who then makes a valiant attempt to save it. It'll be San Antonio ball. They get a fresh 24 because the ball was punched. Spurs up by 9. The time to get San Antonio has been in the first couple of games of each of these playoff rounds. Even though they've lost only one game, it was a home game, first round, game two here against the Timberwolves, and several of their victories on their home floor in the first two games of each of the series have been very close. Last possession wins. They had a discussion, and they decided not to reset the 24. In any case, Elliott misses with the scoop on the drive. Here's Charlie Ward, inside to Johnson, in traffic, he's fouled. When the Spurs have gone on the road, that's when they've really brought the hammer down in games 3 and 4 at Minnesota, 3 and 4 at L.A., 3 and 4 in Portland.
And interestingly enough, most of that has come with more bench help, and Bob, that sort of goes against conventional wisdom. Normally your bench is not as effective on the road. You count more on your starters, and your bench helps you more at home. That has not been the case with San Antonio.
Malik Rose was his third, and Johnson hits the first.
You know, with all the fouls and all that's going on, New York, it's only an 8-point game right now. The game is right there in the balance for them. They're in good position. They've got to generate some offense. And, you know, Bob, we've said this as we've covered the Spurs in the playoffs. Teams have to find ways to score against this team, and it's very, very difficult because of that shot blocking.
The Knicks, as most New York fans know, were 21-21 and in danger of not making the playoffs. Since then, they're 17-6, end of the regular season and playoffs combined. But to put it in perspective, the Spurs were 6-8, and since then, they're 42-6.
And again, showed great patience. They fired Popovich, trade David Robinson. They stayed with it. They let it play itself out. The guys worked into the rotations. They accepted the roles, and you see what's happened since.
Apparently a little bit of blood on the face of Malik Rose. And according to NBA rules, he has to come out of the game until they close the wound. And Tim Duncan comes back playing with 3 fouls. San Antonio by 7. Mario Elliott. Set shot short. The rebound to Camby. Sprewell blows by Elliott, gives it up to Johnson. Now here's Camby against Robinson, leaning in and scoring.
That's what he brings, energy. You don't have to run plays for him, and he'll manufacture points by being out there with activity. And again, Bob, they've got themselves right back into it. It's only a 5-point game right now. They've got to stay out of foul trouble here, though.
Duncan turns to face the basket against Johnson. An illegal defense is called against New York. That's the second, so it's a technical.
What New York is trying to do defensively is they're not making a double team. They're trying to dig back in there and get help and then get back to their own people. And they've got caught a couple times getting below that illegal defensive area. And they've been whistled for it now. That's a technical, and they get the score.
Mario Elie hits the tee. Tim Duncan, Ward coming over to help Johnson. The turnaround is good.
They're going to have to give him some help. Larry Johnson has got fouls. Tim Duncan is way too big. I think Jeff Van Gundy's going to have to take some chances here and make San Antonio make some outside jump shots.
Duncan's first basket of the second half gives him 21. Houston's pass intercepted by Elliott. The trailer is Sean Elliott. Poked away from him by Camby. Loose ball to the side, out of bounds, touch last by Duncan.
New York needs Marcus Camby. Energy, quickness. He has the size and length to finish around the basket over Duncan and Robinson. He gives him a layup. But then Tim Duncan with the counter. In the post, he takes his time. No hurry. Reads the defense. Charlie Ward comes down. goes back, steps in between the double team and just too big and tall, and finishes against Larry Johnson.
Nick Paul, when we come back.
Ahmad Rashad back in San Antonio where the Spurs lead the Knicks 54-46. Now, here is a contingent from the West Indies, the Virgin Islands. 125 people took a charter flight over just for the day to come over and support Tim Duncan. Tim Duncan, of course, being the man that he is, got him all Bob Uecker seats. And he also, they also have a sign up there that says, Tim Duncan, MVP of the world. Bob?
Ahmad, thanks. Duncan from San Croix in the Virgin Islands. The pass inside for Houston is broken up. It'll still be New York ball.
Well, during that timeout, Jim Gray heard Jeff Van Gundy say to Larry Johnson, he's got to get more involved in the offense. They need him to step out on the floor. He can shoot that little medium-range jump shot when David Robinson goes for a shot block. So he's got to be more aggressive.
Houston working on Ellie, running one-hander, no good. Rebound off Robinson's hands, but it bounces to Elliott. Spurs by Aiden with the ball. Duncan spinning on Johnson. And the contingent from the Virgin Islands can erupt on that. You know, his primary sport was swimming as a teenager. And Hurricane Hugo ruined his high school's pool one year. And he was too afraid of sharks to swim in the ocean and train. And he turned his attentions to basketball primarily. So the Spurs may have Steven Spielberg to thank for their good fortune. The jumper by Sprewell is short, but how about the follow? Man, Canby just stuffed it through.
Well, that's what we saw against Indiana. And unfortunately for New York in this game, he picked up three quick fouls, and he's really been out of it offensively. Maybe he can come to life here.
Here's Avery Johnson. Spurs by 10. Ward. Got it. Charlie Ward with 7. Robinson looking for Duncan. And finding him.
What makes these two guys so great together is they both can pass the ball. David made a great pass away from the defense, and Tim Duncan went up and caught it, brought it down, and finished and scored. Bob, one can go inside, the other outside. They play beautifully together.
Duncan's got 25.
You can see already 25 points tonight. And it seems like the Spurs always pick out that one matchup that is good for them. Tonight has been Tim Duncan.
And how's this for efficiency? He has those 25 points on 13 shots. He's 10 for 13. And how cold is New York since the first quarter? Symbolized by Allan Houston, who hit 5 of his first 6. He's 1 for 5 since then. Robinson on Johnson. 5 seconds to shoot. Larry Johnson spinning. Knocked back in his face, recovered by Canby, who beats the shot clock, but comes up empty. Johnson hustling after it, but can't quite come up with it. It's Avery Johnson for San Antonio. Sean Elliott all alone. Got it. Traffic finds Johnson, and then the tip for Canby. Robinson knocked away from him by Canby. Loose ball scooped up by Houston. Here comes Sprewell. Around Elliott, lays it in.
Bob, something's wrong with Marcus Canby. He's been a little gimpy getting down the floor both times on that play. He knocked the ball away from Robinson and was very slow getting up.
Meanwhile, Sprewell on the dribble can move as fast as most people can run flat out. Duncan had it knocked away. It's still San Antonio ball. Five on the shot clock.
Marcus Camby holding his side there. I don't know if he got kicked in the leg or got the breath knocked out of him, but boy, he's got to hang in there, Bob. He's come to life in this quarter and given them some baskets around the rim, something they desperately needed.
Here's Jaren Jackson, 2 seconds to shoot. Jackson does, and the Spurs have now made their last six shots from the field as they begin to pull away.
So they had no outside shooting in the first half. It was all post-up Duncan Robinson. Now the outside guys are starting to get free.
Sprewell quiets the crowd just a bit. He scored 14. Robinson into the corner for Elliott. He hits the three.
Inside, outside.
From virtually the same spot where he hit the back-breaking three against the Trailblazers in Game 2 of the Conference Finals. Sprewell has it squared away. Robinson grabs it. Avery Johnson, a blind pass for Jaren Jackson, but they lose it. Here's Houston. A pull-up jumper is good.
Well, Allan Houston answers there, and that's uncharacteristic of Avery Johnson. Very rarely do you ever see him trying to make a spectacular play, and that time it cost him.
Here's Duncan, guarded by Thomas, driving on him, off-balance shot, no good. Into the arms of Camby, who is still a bit gimpy as he heads back to the other end of the floor. Sprewell again, good again.
This guy's unbelievable. He's got more energy. He can't wait to get the ball in his hands.
Do you think he's phased by any of this?
I know he's not tired. He can't wait to get it again.
Be trying to contend with Robinson. That leaves Jackson wide open, and he knows what to do.
You know, that's why Jeff Van Gundy didn't want to double team the post. The guys are in foul trouble. Now he's got to give them help. Now you're turning loose the shooters.
Sprewell can't answer this time. Line drive rebound to Sean Elliott. After a pair of threes, they lead by 10. Last minute of the third. Robinson into the paint and a whistle.
Bob, we go back a few minutes. Now, Camby knocks that ball loose from David Robinson. And as the ball was picked up by Allan Houston, they touch it. You see Camby get up, and he's really limping right there. Since that point in time, he's really been favoring that leg.
And now he's picked up his fourth foul. Sending Robinson to the line. Searching for a parallel. Oscar Robertson averaged 25 points a game his last year with the Royals in 1970. Went to Milwaukee to join Lou Alcindor, as he was then known. Ultimately, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Lowered that to 19, became the secondary guy, and they won the NBA title. Robinson has become the secondary guy here, and the Spurs are odds on to win their first title. They lead here by 11 in game one. Whistle, illegal defense. Let's check with Jim Gray.
All right, thanks, Bob. But Mike Saunders right now is wrapping the left knee of Marcus Camby. It's a contusion that he suffered on his knee. Don't know right now his status. Camby indicated when he came back to the bench that it was bothering him, that he wanted to continue later in the game. We'll find out more and pass it on. Bob.
Thanks, Jim. Both teams have now been hit with two illegal defense calls. Houston swishes the technical foul shot. New York ball, they trail by 10.
35 seconds on the game clock. Can they get a quick shot, a 2-for-1? If they get a couple scores here, Bob, get this under 10, they're still in the ball game.
Houston for three. It rattles in and out. Would have been a big one. Rebound tapped to the side. Sprewell saves it to Johnson. Wow, what a play. Here's Kurt Thomas inside from Ward.
Great hustle that time by New York, and then Kurt Thomas used his body nicely to go away from David Robinson to get that basket. And with all this said and done, now it's an 8-point game. New York hanging in there.
Foul to give for the Knicks here if they choose to. Jaren Jackson out of the corner to Steve Kerr. Up top, Sean Elliott. Here's the Admiral. Partially blocked and out of bounds with 2.9 seconds on the clock.
Now, the reason they're not getting under the basket, he said it went behind the backboard and hit the support, so they'll get it sideline out of bounds. He said about 2.9, they've got to get a quick shot.
Elliott into Kerr, Malik Rose, and Larry Johnson got a piece of that. Spurs led by 8 at the half. They lead by 8 entering the fourth quarter.
New York is not going to go away. They're showing great hustle and great heart. Sprewell with the save. He kicks the ball back in. It'll be a nice pass underneath from Charlie Ward to Kurt Thomas, the shot blocker. David Robinson is there. You seal him with your body. You go away from contact, and you get the score.
Back after these words from your local station.
New York down by 8 as we go into the fourth, and we spoke to Jeff Van Gundy yesterday. He said, we know there are 5 things we can control. And these are the 5 things. Fast break points, the Knicks are +5. Second chance points, none for the Spurs. They're winning the battle of the bench. 3-point shooting, basically even. The difference really has been the fouls and the free throw. So New York is in pretty good shape right now, Bob. Down 8, and they had a 26-point third quarter, so their offense is back on track right now.
Jaren Jackson with it, but not for long. Kurt Thomas cuts in front of Tim Duncan for the steal. Fourth quarter opens on a good note for the Knicks. Sprewell cross court to Larry Johnson. Up top, Charlie Ward. Now it's Houston for 3. Rebound fought for, out of bounds. And touch last by Thomas of the Knicks. The report on Marcus Camby from Jim Gray over by the New York bench. Left knee contusion. He will be back.
Well, that would have been a big shot by Allan Houston. That would have made it a 5-point game.
Steve Kerr lobbing for Duncan. 2 defenders on him. Cross court to Elliott. His 3. No good. Bounces up. Hits the shot clock. New York ball.
I expect New York to be much more aggressive defensively in the double teams in this fourth quarter. It might be that they were saving their double teams to get into the fourth quarter to force them to shoot the ball from the perimeter. You saw the quick double team that time. New York, a very small team on the floor. No Dudley, can be hurt, and Larry Johnson right now is still a little bit gimpy, but a very small team for New York. Quickness, speed, they want to penetrate and make shots.
Charlie Ward turns and asks for a timeout. Chris Dudley was at the scorer's table getting ready to check in, so he'll be in the New York lineup when play resumes. 10:52 to play in the fourth. Spurs by 8.
The reason Jeff Van Gundy took that timeout is you're going to see Larry Johnson here on this play. He gets that right leg extended. And remember, he had the brace taken off in that first half. So he looks like he hyperextends that leg a little bit, the one that was so sore coming into this game. Jeff Van Gundy took the timeout to talk to him. Get one more look here. You see it's the right leg. And you can just see he overextends it just a little bit. Nothing serious, but when it's that sore, and you see Larry Johnson now sitting on the bench, and again, he took that brace off, which makes him more susceptible to re-injuring that leg.
Johnson has played 17 minutes tonight. He scored 5 points, taken 1 rebound. Houston was fouled as we go to Jim Gray.
All right, Bob, the report from Mike Saunders, the Knicks trainer, is Larry Johnson tweaked his knee a little bit, twisted it slightly. He refused any treatment, any ice. He wants to return to the game and probably will. Bob?
Jim, thanks again. The foul on Jaren Jackson was his 4th. Johnson watches his teammate Houston go to the line and hit the first. Allen's wife Tammy gave birth to a baby girl this week, little Remy.
A I was kidding Allan before the game. I said, Allan, you'll go to any cost to be able to get out of a practice. I said, you tell your coach you'll get a big game in game six. He had 32. They eliminate Indiana. His wife goes into labor on Saturday. He misses practice. I said, you'll do anything. But congratulations to Allan and his beautiful wife.
Addy brings them to within six. Melly out of the backcourt with a toss to Kerr. Jackson looking inside for Malik Rose. He's covered, so Jackson takes a wild off-balance three. And that's the kind of season and playoff run it's been for San Antonio.
I just watched Jeff Van Gundy. The look on his face said it all. He could not believe that shot went in the basket.
Six on the shot clock. Childs holding it. They've got to get something away. It's Childs over Kerr. And the rebound taken by Ellie.
Now that could be a critical play as New York tries to get back into this game. This, they score here, and it goes from 6 to 11 very quickly to thwart that rally.
Jaren Jackson drives around Sprewell and loses it. Man, that shot he hit a moment ago was ridiculous.
Reminiscent of Sean Elliott falling out of bounds, keeping his feet in bounds as he took that shot.
Here's Allen Houston spinning. Left hand. Missed it badly. Rebound to Duncan. Mario Elie on the wing to Jackson. His three is short. Elie trying to save it, but into the hands of Sprewell. Trailing the play is Childs, and he connects.
You know, Sprewell is one of those guys you play with. He's bringing so much energy. He almost drags you along with him. If you're going to play, you better run.
You're pulled in on his vapor trail.
Absolutely. He just drags you along.
Steve Kerr out high. Into the lane. His shot is blocked. Camby got a hand on it. It squirts out of bounds, and the Knicks will have it. Greg Popovich trusts his bench here. In the fourth quarter, he has three reserves in. Jackson, Ellie, and Kerr.
Well, he's going to come back with David Robinson right now. He does not want any more to be whittled off this lead. It's a seven-point game right now, so he'll come back in. David Robinson for Rose.
I misspoke. Jackson, Rose, and Kerr. Ellie, of course, one of their starters.
David cannot get in. He was not at the scorer's table, so he'll have to wait a possession. Let's see if New York can take advantage of that, maybe get to the basket.
Sprewell finding Camby. Little touch pass over to Thomas and a foul. That's four on Malik Rose.
You see more teams doing this now. Out of the double team, Bob, they cut a man right to the basket, and they just sort of lob the ball up. He goes and gets it, and he's either a passer or he drops that ball off. This time he got the foul.
Misses the first tonight. When the ball game is over, the late night action begins. First, the Tonight Show with Jay Leno. Among the guests, Dennis Rodman. And it's Late Night with Conan O'Brien. Conan has ER's Noah Weiler. The Tonight Show and Late Night with Conan O'Brien coming up on NBC. Childs reaching in and fouling Mario Elie. That's number two on Chris, who was in the Spurs training camp back in 93. He was cut by John Lucas.
San Antonio must go back inside to Robinson and Duncan. You've got Camby and Thomas in the game. You've got to go with what worked for you in the first half. That's the two big guys inside.
Jaren Jackson surrounded. Knicks putting the pressure on, and Jackson asks for a timeout. Thank you. pass comes to Robinson, who scored only 1 point in the second half. He puts it on the floor and draws the foul.
Now, the Knicks game plan has been, during the playoffs, stick around, especially on the road, and let's see if we can win this game at the end. They're there. It's a six-point game. More importantly, Bob, after 20 first-half free throws for San Antonio, only three in the second half, the Knicks have kept them off the foul line.
Camby just picked up his fifth. He sits. Johnson comes back in. Tim Duncan gives it up to Jackson. Jaren Jackson.
Right on time.
Man. He has just been huge throughout this playoff run for the San Antonio Spurs. Sprewell. Tip try by Thomas won't fall. And Duncan protects the rebound. Spurs by nine. And as Jackson tries to find Robinson inside, Larry Johnson was holding the Admiral.
The reason Jaren Jackson is getting so open is because Duncan and Robinson are creating so many opportunities. This time, the dribble penetration and the kick, that was your 7-1 center, dribble penetrating and finding the shooter in the corner.
Four fouls on Johnson. Duncan open. Short from 20. Rebound snatched down by Sprewell. He weaves his way into the front court. Finds Chris Childs. The bounce back inside to Sprewell. Now Larry Johnson. Off the glass, no good. Mario Elie misses the reverse. Tough attempt and it almost fell for it. Racehorse pace, Kurt Thomas. Robinson cuts him off. He turns and tries the jumper over him, and a foul on the play. It'll be number three on Robinson.
Foul trouble is still a big story right now when you look at about 7:04 to go in this ball game. David Robinson picks up his third. You see Camby with five, Johnson with four, Dudley and Houston with three. Jackson and Rose with four, both those guys off the bench. Duncan and Robinson still in good shape with only three.
Sprewell's jumper is off. Robinson has the rebound. And Steve Jabby blows his whistle. Kurt Thomas is hit with his third.
The Knicks big men are working so hard to keep that ball away from the post, and San Antonio does a nice job swinging that ball to get a good angle to throw it in there, and Kurt Thomas caught that time with the foul, but they're working so hard inside.
Johnson trying to find Robinson, broken up by Larry Johnson, and he'll pick up number five.
Tell your guys, play defense before the guy catches the ball. And you see Larry Johnson this time working hard. Little touch foul there over the top. More importantly, that will be the team fifth. So San Antonio will shoot free throws the rest of the game. And now Larry Johnson has five fouls. See, the problem you have with this is when you have to play Dudley in the fourth quarter, he's a poor free throw shooter. But more importantly, Bob, he's not a threat to make a shot out on the floor. So now San Antonio's big men can really gamble on Sprewell and Houston.
But Van Gundy's hand has been forced. One of two for Robinson, who scored 13 points, has eight rebounds and six assists.
Bob, I think you see also, too, the refs are really calling this game close. It's been something we've seen all the playoffs. They're trying to clean up post play.
Sprewell splits the defense, but it's shoved back into space by Robinson. Thomas keeps it alive. Sprewell tries it again. And Robinson comes away with it. Chris Childs breaks it up, stepping in front of Avery Johnson. His pass deflected out of bounds by Jaren Jackson. New York ball.
David Robinson is playing Dudley, so he can come over and give help. That's what I talked about when you're playing 4-on-5 offensively right now. Dudley's got to get to that offensive board because he's not a primary player. Maybe get a tip in.
The Knicks, trailing by 10, have shot 1-for-9 so far on the fourth.
Both of these teams are such terrific defensive teams. The Spurs do it with shot blocking.
Allan Houston in the lane to Sprewell. Tries to slither through and lost it.
see, if Larry Johnson or Camby are in the game, you can kick out and maybe make a shot. Both Kurt Thomas and Dudley are thinking rebound. There's no spacing there to make a pass. Sprewell, Houston have no place to go right now in the offense.
Duncan turning on Dudley and scoring. 27 for Tim Duncan.
He is so good. I love his composure. Bob, as I've said many times before, I would never want to play poker against this guy. You wouldn't know what he was holding.
Timeout, New York. The cheers cascade down from the rafters. 39,514 whooping it up.
5:24 to go. And Bob, what's happened to me in this game is San Antonio got off to a little slow start. New York jumped on them. They were a little rusty. They've gotten their legs, and they've done it by pounding the ball inside, going to their big people who've really softened up the defense and really forced New York to be in terrible foul trouble early in this game.
Here's Childs around the Johnson screen. Now returns it to Larry. 10 on the shot clock. Here's Allen Houston. Robinson comes over and blocks it. Into the hands of Duncan. Avery Johnson on the wing to Mario Elie. Slings it to the corner for Jaren Jackson. And they'll set it back up. Inside 5 minutes to play in the fourth. Duncan. He's got 29.
Just no answer. They don't have any size. They've got to go to a smaller team. They've got to have some offense on the floor. But Larry Johnson has got to look for that jump shot. Bob, looks like he's had a couple threes, and he just hasn't felt comfortable taking them.
Spurs by 14, the game's biggest lead. Childs on the move to the left hand. Missed it. Thomas follows and connects. Spurs looking to win their 11th consecutive playoff game. That would tie the record held by the 89 Lakers. Duncan's jumper is short. Rebound is taken by Kurt Thomas. Sprewell penetrates. Just exploding to the hoop, but it rolls off the lip of the rim.
Tough break that time by Sprewell. Just, as you said, just speeded to the rim. Just got a tough roll there.
Avery Johnson and a whistle. Before the shot, no basket. A reminder, following the game on most of these NBC stations, it's the late local news, then the Tonight Show. For those of you who'd like to continue with coverage of the finals, there's a post-game special on CNBC immediately following the game.
I think that'll be with our buddies Bill Walton and Steve Jones, correct? You guys did a great job covering the Eastern Conference Finals.
Snapper and Bill, never short for an opinion or for a disagreement. The team of Jones and Walton on CNBC after the game. Avery Johnson comes up empty. Johnson out, Camby in for the Knicks. Allan Houston trying to make something happen and can't. The rebound to Robinson.
Ellie's doing a good job. He's really keeping him out of the lane, bumping him and forcing him to take some tough shots. Looks like Allen's getting a little tired.
Elie playing a two-man game with Duncan, who takes it to the hoop. Doesn't get the roll, but the tip is credited to Duncan, and now he has 31. 31 for Tim Duncan. Exactly 3 minutes to play. Knicks down 14. Their run of game one victories on the road about to end.
Bob, in the fourth quarter, Sprewell and Houston are a combined 0-for-8. And what I think you've seen is what we talked about, how hard they're working to get their scores. Allen or Sprewell, they beat somebody off the dribble. They run into either Duncan or Robinson. They have to work so hard for their shots. They're just wearing down right now.
New York trailed by 8 at the start of the quarter. Here's Childs. It would have been a 2. It's no good. Thomas clears it, gives them another try. New York is now 2-for-15 in this quarter, and they've scored but 7 points. Make it 9 as Thomas swishes one off the baseline. But they still trail by a dozen. Jaren Jackson. Now David Robinson. He has it back. Jackson fires a 3 and puts the Knicks away.
You gotta pick your poison. Do you take it away from the big guys? If you do, the Spurs have come up with timely shooting all throughout the playoffs. Tonight, once again, it's Jaren Jackson playing instead of Sean Elliott in the fourth quarter.
Sprewell answers with a 3, but too little, too late. Perhaps appropriate that tonight it's the former ABA team who has hit the majority of the threes. Spurs have 6 of them. Sprewell's was just New York's 2nd. The pass from Jackson for Robinson actually hit the rim. New York claims it. Robinson pokes it away. Duncan with a great save. What hasn't he done tonight? Duncan had it stripped, but there was a foul.
When you have a post player, you go inside to him. If they double team it, you trust and you kick it out. Child slow on the rotation getting there, and you see Jaren Jackson, he's loving it. You said you got to pick your poison, and Bob, I think as you go into game 2, if you're Jeff Van Gundy, do you start out the game early by doing more double teaming and protect your team against fouls? Try to keep your guys on the floor. That frees up the 3-point shooting. So you've got to make a decision here what you want to do. But they have got to protect Larry Johnson and Camby. They need those guys on the floor.
Duncan missed the first. Looks for his 32nd point, and there it is. The 89 Lakers swept all their playoff series leading to the finals, winning 11 straight games. Then they themselves were swept by the Pistons with Byron Scott and Magic Johnson hurt. Tonight, the Spurs equal the Lakers' record, winning their 11th consecutive playoff game. Duncan knocked away, and another trip to the foul line. Another reminder, right after the game, on most of these NBC stations, it's your late local news, then the Tonight Show. But for those of you who want more basketball, switch over to CNBC on cable. There'll be a full post-game report. Isaiah Thomas, Peter Vesey, Hannah Storm, the always enjoyable team of Snapper Jones and Bill Walton, interviews with players and coaches. That's immediately following the game on CNBC. Avery Johnson and David Robinson go out to thunderous applause.
As we talked in our open, the Spurs have faced 3 different kind of teams in the first 3 rounds. Minnesota, they said Avery Johnson is going to beat us. Bob, he's only taken about 1 or 2 shots tonight. In round 2, it was Tim Duncan. In round 3, Robinson. Tonight, the big Twin Towers again and the timely shooting of Jaren Jackson. They have the right pieces around those big guys, and they've seen every kind of defense, and they've adjusted.
Camby stuffed home Sprewell's whirling miss, but it's all just bookkeeping now. 89-77. Duncan's jumper. Thomas a rebound. Childs for 3. Ellie has it. 4-on-2. Antonio Daniels. Jaren Jackson. Thought about a 3, won't take it. Daniels with a fadeaway. Sprewell runs it down as the clock runs down. The rebound is taken by Duncan. That puts a capper on his night. a night which saw him score 33 points, take 16 boards, and block two shots. Game one to the Spurs.
27-point first quarter, 50 points thereafter. The thing you talk about, how do you score against the Spurs? Portland only 76 a game tonight, New York 77. Once again, the Spurs defense and the Twin Towers.
And we go to Ahmad Rashad.
All right, thanks, Bob. Tim, you can tell the time off. You guys were a little bit rusty at the start of the game, but started to get in the flow towards the end of the second quarter.
Yeah, we knew we'd come out a little rusty, and we'd have a little time to get into it, but we know we played 48 minutes, played all the way through, and we just got back into it.
In the first half, not many outside shots. In the second half, you started to open up. What opened it up for you, Jared?
We finally got into some rhythm. I was able to start hitting my shots. I hit a tough one in the corner, but I got into a little rhythm. Tim was feeding me outside the post. And we just played a solid game tonight.
All right, confidence-wise, what's this win do for you?
Oh, it feels great to get this first one, knowing that we had those 10, 11 days off, and to come back here and play as well as we did down the stretch. It's great for us, and we know we can play better.
And you played great for those fans up there that came in from your
hometown. Yeah, great. It was great to have them here. It's just an awesome feeling.
All right, thank you. Congratulations, guys.